drive too fast for y'all, man. Drive too fast, drive too furious. Oh, I'm too fast for y'all, man.
You just came home from doing a bit. Tell me what you gonna do, not the fool.
What's going on, YouTube? Manuel Sauce here, and today we are going to teach you how to deal with those puck ragging, neutral zone trap playing French Canadians. And now, you're probably asking, how do I know if I've got a French Canadian that I'm playing against? Well, the number one indicator that you are playing against a French Canadian will happen before the game. If they have QC in their gamer tag or in their team name, they are a French Canadian. And I want to make a quick note here. I mean, no offense to the entire province of Quebec, but you guys really just need to teach your people not to play Chell like a bunch of assholes. Now, these Frenchies, when they get the puck, what they'll do is they'll hold the puck back behind their skates as if that's, like, humanly possible to do in a real hockey game without getting your fucking head taken off. They'll hold the puck back behind their skates, so every time you try to poke check, it's a tripping penalty, but for some reason you try to hit them and it does absolutely nothing. So I'm going to teach you how to deal with those dang French Canadians in today's video. And first things first, if you get matched up with a Frenchie and you win the opening faceoff, what you want to do is just sit there with the puck and see if he's going to play the trap or not. And if he is going to play the trap, just sit there and wait him out. Make him pissed at his own gameplay. Just win that thing back, either tie up, counter whatever he's doing, get that puck back to your defenseman, and just sit there with it. And if he drops back and controls his center and just drops back behind his own defenseman, you've got a Frenchie. And what you want to do with that is just rag it. Just sit there and make him forecheck you. You can sit there all period if you want. Who gives a shit? He's not scoring on you. See, there he goes right there holding the puck behind him. These are the type of guys that will play an entire game with six shots on goal and will somehow score four goals on you. And they'll beat you in time on attack by about 6 minutes because all they do is puck rag and they don't shoot the puck. They just hold it from side to side behind them, behind their skates, so you can't poke it without taking a penalty. And they are the worst type of people to play against. But the thing about this is they spend so much time in the offensive zone just wiggling around with the puck, holding it behind them, stick handling back and forth, making sure you can't poke check them. These guys are more interested in drawing a tripping penalty than actually trying to score a goal. So that's going to work to your advantage. And the first thing you're going to want to do when you get the puck on offense is play their own game. If they want to play that puck-ragging Frenchie-style gameplay, do it right back to them. Because I'm going to tell you right now, they're not going to be as good at playing defense as they are at just wiggling around in the offensive zone. Because they don't get a lot of practice in their D zone. Because they're going to beat most teams in time on attack by 4 or 5 minutes almost. So when you get time in the offensive zone against them, beat them at their own game. Rag the puck. Hold it behind your skates. Wiggle around the zone. See right there, he was in the slot. He didn't shoot it. Why didn't he shoot it? He had a great opportunity and he just passed it up. And then look, the Frenchie gets an EA bounce and now he is set up to play the trap for the rest of the game. He is up 1-0. He doesn't give a flying fuck. If he scores another goal this game, he's going to trap his ass off and nurse that one goal lead until you do something stupid, run at one of his players, then he gets an odd man rush, and then it's 2-0, and then he can really nurse that lead. So basically, the best way to counter this type of gameplay is to use their own system against them. If you start playing like him, he's going to get frustrated. He's going to be like, man, why does this guy play like that? Dude, you play like that. So when you start using his system against him, there you go, get one right back on him with a nice play. I make a good play, pass through the slot, cut across the crease, tuck that thing home, make a great play. It's tied 1-1 because he got an EA bounce and I had to earn my goal, because that's what happens when you play against these people. For some reason, EA caters to the worst type of players online and gives them every bounce possible. So you got to fight through it. You got to use their system. Right there, I just put the puck behind my leg so he couldn't do nothing with it, and he's not going to like that. I'm using his system right back at him, and he's going to be pissed because now he's going to start taking penalties when I'm sitting there with the puck behind my skates, and he's going to be like, man, I hate playing against people that play like this. And right now, I'm absolutely taking it to him. I'm in his offensive zone. My forecheck's on point. I'm making passes. I'm getting backdoor one-timers. For some reason, they don't want to go in when they go in for everyone else. But this is a great shift going right now. And when you dominate in the offensive zone, they are going to run around like crazy. They're going to be rattled because they're not used to being in their defensive zone for extended periods of time because they are not good defensive players. They are puck-ragging offensive players. So when you get a lead on them, that's when their play style really starts to hit the shitter. Like right now, his computer's on the forecheck. Just hold the puck away from him. The computer will take a penalty if you hold the puck away from the computer while he's forechecking you. He was smart right there, and he switched to control that guy so his computer wouldn't take a penalty. So obviously, he's experienced at sending his computer on the forecheck for him to do the greasy work for him. And that's another thing that these guys will do. They will send their computer on the forecheck against you. They will let their computers play defense for them. And if someone wants to sit back and let their computers play defense for them, there's a couple ways to exploit that. One, if you are side by side with a computer D and you think you have the angle, try to burn them to the shortest post on the net. Try to burn them to that short side post, and depending what side you're on, either go forehand, backhand, or backhand, forehand, and try to get that glitch cheese goal on that little short side breakaway move. See if you can get that. And if you are not past the defenseman, one way you can counter someone letting their computers play defense for them is to just take a cheese wrister. You get into the slot, let their computers back down, use their computer D as a screen on their goalie, and cut across to the middle and shoot back short side for that cheese wrister, and that is a great way to exploit the computer defense players. And now, as you can see, this guy got one waved off for goalie interference, so at this point, this kid is pissed. He is frustrated. His play style is not working for him right now. He gets one lucky bounce. He can't get this lucky bounce to go because he runs into the goalie. So I'm still up 2-1 here towards the end of the first period. This kid is absolutely rattled right now. You're taking his play style, shoving it right back up his ass. Look at this. This is how you get him. This is how you get him. He doesn't want a forecheck. He doesn't want to commit to that forecheck. And then you get past him, and you're gone. You're in. If I don't run into my own player right there, I might have the short side cheese breakaway, but the time runs out anyway. So we're up 2-1 at the end of the first. That is a great position to be in against these Frenchie-style players. So going into the second, we're going to stick to the same game plan. Look, his computer's forechecking. He switched to that player because he didn't want him to take a penalty. Now we've got him. Now we've got him. We've got the puck going. We're in the offensive zone now. He's sending that guy up to forecheck. He gets past him, and you're off. You're off to the races. You're breaking into the zone. You can set up your cycle, drop it back to the D, send it down low, whatever it may be. Get them cross-crease one-timers going, them D-to-D one-timers. You're set up in the offensive zone. But now here he goes. He's still just wiggle around, keep on wiggling. Ooh, but the pass can't go. Now you're out. That is the number one way you're going to get rushes against this style of player is turnovers. You're not going to just have complete control of the puck and be able to break in clean very easily because he's just going to drop back. He's going to send all five guys back to play defense. He is not going to forecheck whatsoever. So if you get a turnover in the defensive zone, you deflect one of his passes away or something, take the rush, jump it, and go. Take off as fast as you can, and there we go. It's 3-1. We're up 3-1 against this French-Canadian, and you got to get the puck chop in there to show a little disrespect on that goal celebration to let him know who's boss, let him know who's better, and now look, you take his medicine right back to him. You give him a dose of it. Look, he still doesn't want to forecheck. He doesn't want to forecheck, and now you're past him. He had to do it. He had to take control of that guy. Now you're past him. Now you're in the zone, and you're set up on offense once again, even though EA wants to do some stupid shit like that and give him a breakaway. But look, he has no clutch genes in him. If finishing ability was a stat trait, this guy's stat would be zero. But anyway, here in the second period, up 2 goals on a kid that likes to play the trap, likes to hold the puck behind his legs and rag it, try to get you to take a penalty. This is a great situation to be in. You go up 2+ on a kid like this, they're going to start to panic. They're going to start taking risks that they normally wouldn't take, and it's going to start to open up the offensive zone more for you. You're going to get more quality chances. You're going to get more chances on the rush because he's going to start to step up because he wants you to turn that puck over, and you're not going to do it. Don't bite into his stuff. There goes a backdoor one-timer. Can't get it to go. But yeah, at this point, this kid's going to start to step up on you a little bit. So all you got to do is give that little one move to the side, and you're in. You're in on a rush. You're in on a 2-on-1. You might be in on a 1-on-0 little short side breakaway chance. You might be in the offensive zone, and he puck chases a little bit. You might be able to get a backdoor one-timer. or if he tries to sit there and camp on the one-timer, you're going to be able to take a wrister on the short side. So you've got options now. This kid's going to start taking chances. You've got options in the offensive zone. You're up 2 goals, 1 more, and you might be able to get the kid to rage quit out of the game because he's like, screw this, I'm not coming back from 3 goals. But anyway, he tries to rag out the icing. He tries to cheese that icing and let the puck go all the way, and instead I beat it out. He takes a tripping penalty, and this kid is livid. What's going to happen here? His man's going to the box, and wait for it. Wait for it. It's coming. Bingo, you have lost connection to your other players. This kid rage quit. And what do you do when that happens? You let him know you're there. You send him a message and you say, hey man, how's it going? Oh, just a little smiley face to brighten your day. Let him know you beat him. Let him know who's boss. Hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe. And go drop a comment on the most recent video before this one to be entered in our NHL 18 Hut giveaway.